The word of God says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5, God is saying like this, I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. I called you before you were even born. That tells me that there's a call of God upon our life. And the call and the purpose from God has come long ago, before we were even born. That means we are all called to do something very specific. Purpose to do something very, very specific by God. You know, I've heard people saying that to somebody, you have a big call on your life. I understand what they're trying to say is that the influence will be on a lot of people. But let me tell you, this is not my call or your call. This is the call of God upon my life and the call of God upon your life. So the one who's calling is God, and God is a big God. So the one who is calling is big. That means anybody who you are, your call is big, because your call is by God Himself. You know, if God tells us to do something and we fail to do it or we do not do it, that is called disobedience. We all know that. But if God does not tell you to do something and you still go ahead and do it, what is that? That is also disobedience. Now, for example, I try to help my wife. I have a good heart. So I try to help my wife and do some things for her. And whenever I spend my time, energy in doing something in the kitchen or wherever in the house, and she'll come after some time and she'll say, what have you done? I'm like, I was trying to help you. I wanted to help you. You're doing so much work. She's like, please don't help me. Do only what I tell you to do. Maybe God is like that sometime. If He tells you to do something, please make sure you do it. But if He does not tell you to do something, it's okay. Maybe everybody is called for something different. There's no competition. We are all running our own race. And we all have to complete our race. There's no competition. We're not competing with each other. So there's no comparison. So in short, we are born to do something. And the real and true satisfaction comes only when the created thing is doing for what it is created. You understand that? If the created thing is doing for what He's created for. People talk about success and fame and money, and they connect all these things to success. But what is true success? True success is doing what I am called to do. What am I exactly called to do? I'm okay with having good bank balance, good house, car. That is all perfect. Everybody wants it. Everybody desires it. But more than that, this true satisfaction comes when we, the created ones, do exactly what we are purposed and fashioned to do by God, called by God before we were born. But the initial steps which leads to this success is what? Is being like the one who has created us. Genesis 1:26, God said, let us create man in our own image. Romans talks about it, that we are predestined to be confined in the image of the Son. So success starts when I have an image of Jesus living out of me. Characteristics of Jesus: humility, the greatest characteristic what I feel about Jesus. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. These are so many things. These are the characteristics of Jesus. Success is when these characteristics are living out of me. I can do great things. I can do great things for God also. But if I'm not humble, if I'm not flowing in the fruits of the Spirit, is that really success all about? And let's take the root. The root of this success is having a good relationship with God, a rich relationship with God. If I don't know who my Creator, who my God is, then I'll never know that who I am in Him. And if I don't know who I am in God, then I will never be able to do what I'm called to do, purpose to do. So it's, in short, I'll just conclude by saying this. Have a rich relationship with your Creator God. Know Him. And when you know Him, you will know who you are in Him. Let Him live out of you. Let His characteristics. He always wanted to represent His image on earth. He told Adam and Eve, go, subdue the earth. That means fill the earth with my image. Today, because of Jesus, He has again restored that image in us. And His desire is the same. Go and subdue my image. First, know Him. Have a rich relationship with Him. Then know who you are in Him, the image, and subdue it. Represent Him well. And then, we'll be able to do what we're actually born to do, called to do, purpose to do. So my prayer for me and you, everybody, is that let us know God, let us know who we are in God, so that we can fulfill what we are called to fulfill and what we are born to fulfill. God bless you.